This morning I want to preach a message to you simply titled, Dreams. Dreams. How many of you have dreams this morning? Raise your hand. If you have dreams this morning, raise your hand. Who's got the biggest dream in the house? Raise your hand. Man, I wish we had hours to listen to them. Who's got the biggest dream in the house? That's what I want to know. Who has the biggest dream in the house? See, already, after you have that question repeated over and over, people start to put their hand down. It's like, maybe. This morning, I want to tell you, I believe in dreams. I believe in dreams. I believe that dreams are a part of God's plan for the redemption of the world. This morning I'm going to show you in Scripture why I believe that. I believe that dreams come from the Lord. Somebody say amen. I believe that God uses dreams to speak to people. If you have your Bibles, you can turn to the book of Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2, we're going to read where Luke repeats something that was spoken years before by the prophet Joel. And it's speaking of the last days. And I got to be honest with you, church. I've heard this all of my life, but I still believe it. We are living in the last days. Somebody say amen. I believe we are living in the last days. I don't believe that there's any question about it. I don't know that this will be the last day, but it very well could be. Nobody knows the day or the hour, but this very well could be. But I believe that we are living in the last days. I believe that the signs of the times are all around us. I believe that there are things that were talked about in Scripture that are happening today. I believe there's still more to come. I believe there are things that Scripture speaks to that have not yet happened, but are going to happen, and I believe that could happen very, very quickly. But I do believe that we are living in the last days. And here's what the prophet Joel said that Luke the apostle repeated. He said, in the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Everybody say all. Say, look at your neighbor, say, that's you. I will pour out my spirit on all people. So, clearly this morning, the scriptures are speaking to all of us. Somebody say amen. When the Bible says all people, that means all of us. Somebody say amen. I will pour out my spirit on all people. And your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions and your old men will dream dreams. And even on my servants, both men and women. All the women say amen. Amen. All the women say amen like you mean it. Amen. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days. And they will prophesy. I will show wonders in the heavens above and signs on the earth below. Move on down to verse 21. This is my favorite part. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And I believe that God wants to give us dreams for his purpose. See, everybody in this room, God's got a plan and a purpose for our lives. And I preach this message often, but because we need to hear it often. Let's say amen. We need to be reminded that God has a plan for our lives. God has a plan for our lives. We make plans, but sometimes they're not God's plans. Sometimes we make a plan, but sometimes they're not God's plans. But I believe that God wants to speak, even in these last days, through dreams and visions. Now, I did a little bit of research this week on dreams versus visions. And there's all kinds of people who write all kinds of strange things about them. But at the very core of it all, here's what I believe. I believe dreams happen when we're asleep, and visions happen when we're awake. And what do we call visions that happen when we're awake? Daydreams. Anybody ever look? So quit daydreaming. Get back to work. Anybody ever daydream? Come on now. I'm with you, Chris. Chris is like, I daydream all the time. I love it. There's times I sit in my office, I look out the window, I just daydream. I daydream about all kinds of stuff, man. But I believe God wants to use dreams and visions in these, the last days, to speak to his people about his plan. And I believe he wants to speak to you. I believe possibly he already has through dreams and visions. But I believe that dreams are a part of God's plan. And I believe God wants to impart dreams in us this morning concerning the future of our lives, of our families, the future of this church, the future of lost people in our world. God wants to impart dreams. And I believe there's a reason for this. And I want to go back to the book of Haggai chapter 2 from even a year ago. It says, the glory of this present house will be greater than the glory of the former house. The glory of this present house will be greater than the glory of the former house, says the Lord Almighty. And in this place I will grant peace, declares the Lord Almighty. And the God is continuing to do mighty things among his people. God is continuing to grow his church. God is continuing to show signs and wonders. I believe that God wants to do that in our lives. See, I'm just optimistic enough to believe that the best is still yet to come. For every one of us in this room, I believe we've not seen God's best yet. I believe there's a whole lot more to see. I believe there's a whole lot more to be revealed. I believe the best is yet to come. And I believe that God continues to have a plan for me, for you, for us, for the ocean, and for all peoples. And I believe when God gives us a dream, those dreams are part of his plan. He's done it throughout history. If you look throughout Scripture, God gave men and women dreams to fulfill his purpose. Jacob had a dream of a ladder with angels ascending and descending up and down, representing the presence of God here on earth. Joseph had a dream about the future of Israel and how God would use him to help sustain his people through times of drought and trial. Not everybody liked his dream. Not everybody's going to like your dream. His own brothers didn't like his dream. But God had a plan. Somebody say amen. But God had a plan. Not everybody's going to like your dream. So I always say, be careful who you share it with. Not everybody's going to like it, but God's used him. God used it in Solomon. Solomon had a dream, and God said, ask whatever you want. Solomon said, give me wisdom. What's God asking you this morning? Even Joseph and Mary had dreams concerning the birth of Jesus. God spoke to them in a dream about their son. God spoke to them in a dream about how to escape. God uses dreams to direct our lives. Joel said that the Holy Spirit would be poured out and dreams and visions would be a result. But let me tell you this morning really fast that not all dreams are from God. Somebody say amen. Not all dreams are from God. And not all dreams are good. But how do we know the difference? I shared this morning, or this week. I shared the simple way that we know that whether or not our dreams are from God is that we measure them through Scripture. We measure them through the Word of God. We measure them through the godly men and women that are in our life that can confirm those dreams. We don't just assume that every dream we have is a God-given dream, but we verify it through the Word of God. We verify it through the people that are around us, those who speak into our lives, godly people that speak into our lives. I believe God's got a dream for all of us today. Ultimately, those dreams are tied to his purpose and his purpose and plan of redemption for mankind. I believe when we look at that prophecy, we find at the very end, all who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And I firmly believe today that every God-given dream points to our God-given destiny. And our God-given destiny is to go into all the world and to preach the gospel and make disciples of every nation. That's God's destiny for the church. And I believe that every dream that God gives us is tied to his purpose and his plan for our life. God doesn't waste a dream. God doesn't waste a dream. And I need you to be reminded of that this morning, because some of you are still waiting for your dreams to come true. Be reminded this morning that God never wastes a dream. God never wastes a dream. God's desire to impart dreams into all of us through the Holy Spirit. And these dreams become the catalyst for direction and guidance in our lives. In fact, the Bible says in Proverbs 29:18, where there is no vision, people perish. I believe this to be the truth. If we stop dreaming, we will start dying. Once we stop dreaming, we start dying. Have you ever met somebody that had no dream for their life? Have you ever met anybody that was just kind of moving along with no direction, no guidance, no dream, just kind of, If you sit down and talk to them, they suck the life out of you. It's like, where are you headed? What are you doing? What's going on in your life? Nowhere, nothing. I mean, what do you want to do? I don't know. You anything good happen in your life? I don't know. It's just like, dude, you got to come alive. Something's got to happen to you. And I believe that if we stop dreaming, we start dying. The Holy Spirit doesn't just impart dreams, but he continues to breathe into our dreams. It's kind of like a balloon. Anybody like balloons? I believe our dreams are a lot like balloons, Edgar. I believe we have those dreams, and all of a sudden, God begins to impart a dream inside of us. And God begins to speak to us, and we begin to think about those dreams. We begin to think about what God's saying to us. And maybe for some of us at the very beginning, it's way too much to handle. I don't know, my dreams are never small. I don't know what that means, but usually when I dream, dreams are way big and outrageous and ridiculous. I wish they weren't, but I guess there's a reason why they are. But as we have those dreams and God speaks to us, we begin to walk accordingly. I had a dream about Tanzania on a mountain in 2007. This year marks a 10-year anniversary of that dream. It started out about like this, with teardrops about this big on top of a mountain down south. I wept like a baby. I had no idea why. Has that ever happened to you? Have you ever just all of a sudden started breaking out in tears and didn't know why? Anybody? Any guys out there do that? Am I the only guy that's ever happened to? It's like you're looking around to see if anybody's watching. Like, what's wrong with me? Girls are supposed to do this. And all of a sudden, God began to impart a dream. Through the years, God begins to do this. The dream gets bigger. Why? Because God breathes into our dreams. If God imparts a dream into our lives, we continue to follow that path. God continues to breathe into that dream. But as God is breathing into our dreams, something's happening. We're being stretched. Those dreams begin to stretch us. Anybody ever been stretched by God's dream? Huh? Come on, some of you I know, because I know what God's speaking to you. And I know that he's stretching you. But it's that stretching that makes us strong. It's the breath of God inside of us that stretches us and makes us strong. Because you see, without the breath of God inside of us, we are weak and feeble. But all of a sudden, when God begins to give us dreams, he stretches us. And all of a sudden, we begin to have purpose. It won't pop. This is how our dreams work. God stretches us. God wants to stretch me this morning. And God wants to stretch you this morning. And God wants to remind us all of his plan for our lives. And he wants to impart dreams inside of all of us concerning that plan. And you say, well, he already has. Well, can I challenge you this morning to just let God do this in your life today? Continue to stretch you to believe and to dream. How many of you this morning, you would say, Pastor Jimmy, God's dream for me, God's dream inside of me, I know it's from him. How many of you say, God's given me a dream? Not my dream, but God's dream for me. It's God's dream for me. It's God's dream for me. I want to remind you this morning again, and I want to say it again just so you understand. I firmly believe that God's dream for our lives are tied to his plan for our lives. God doesn't waste a dream. I believe everything begins with a dream. The church you sit in this morning began with a dream. This family of the ocean that we're a part of began somewhere as a dream. Somebody dreamed it before it came to pass. And here we are today. And we had nothing to do with that dream. But God gave someone a dream. And here we are. I wonder who in the future will be affected by your God-given dream. I wonder who it is that you don't know that will be affected by your God-given dream. They don't even know yet. So I believe those dreams are connected to verse 21 that says, all who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And some people sitting here this morning, you received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior at this church because somebody had a dream. God is speaking to you week after week after week in the ocean, maybe in your connection group, maybe through ministry. I don't know, but it's all a result of somebody's dream years ago that we are able to receive from the ministry of the ocean today. I wonder who it will be, Brian, that will be affected by your dream in years to come. I wonder who it will be, Ben, who's affected by our dreams in years to come. Chris, I wonder what it will look like when we pursue our God-given dreams. I wonder the children whose lives will be affected by the dream you've been willing to dream. And not just their children, Chris, but their children's children. God has a plan for our lives. God has a dream for our lives, and those dreams are connected to our destiny. And our destiny is that all who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That we must pursue our dreams in the power of the Holy Spirit, because it's the Holy Spirit that's poured out that gives us dreams and visions, and we cannot afford to make the mistake of trying to accomplish what is birthed in the Spirit through the power of the flesh. How many times do we try to make our own dreams come true without waiting on God? I have one word for you this morning, Ishmael. If you know the story of Abraham and Sarah, who were promised a son and waited and waited and didn't even believe that God could do it, and Sarah even laughed when the Lord said, you will have a child. She's like, and they waited, it didn't happen, and all of a sudden they took matters into their own hand. Thus we have Ishmael. Anybody got any Ishmaels in your life? Like not real ones, you know what I'm saying? Easy now. Anybody ever try to take God's dream into your own hands and make it happen? And you look back and go, oops. And it's because we try to complete in the flesh what God birthed in the Spirit. It's because we're not patient enough to let God do this. And to allow the Holy Spirit the opportunity to breathe into those dreams. I believe God's dreams take patience. They take time. But I also believe that God doesn't give us dreams without ability to make those dreams come true. I believe that everything we need to make those dreams come true, God has for us. And I think if you look in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and chapter 13, you will see where God has given us the gifts that we need to fulfill the dream he's placed in our hearts. Everything we need to do what God's asking us to do, he's already given us. Everything we need to make these dreams become a reality, God has given us. We call them the gifts of the Spirit. Again, accomplishing in the Spirit what was birthed in the Spirit. If the Holy Spirit gives us dreams, then we must use the Holy Spirit's tools to make them come true. And everything that we need, we've been given. But there are three important things this morning I want to look at very quickly when it comes to dreams. Three keys I think that we need to grab into our hands in order to make these dreams come true. If you have your Bibles, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13 simply says this. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. I want to stop for a moment. I want to take you back because there's really a central theme to all of this stuff about dreams. Verse 21. And all who call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. God's dreams are tied to our destinies. Our destiny is tied to the ultimate plan of God, which is the redemption of the world. Somebody say amen. Are you catching that? Our purpose is to serve God's purpose. Somebody say amen. Your purpose is not about you. My purpose is not about me. Our purpose is to serve God's purpose. And God's purpose is this: that all who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. So our dreams are tied to our destiny, and it's tied to the redemption of the world. God's plan for the ocean is not just about the ocean, but it's about the 7.2 billion people living in the world today. It's about the over 4 billion people that still have never heard the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say amen. We have work to do. The vision of this church is to know Christ and to make him known. And we must continue to be about the Father's business. But so many of us get lost in the enormity of the task and we just sit and say, how? There's just no way. But there is a way. Jesus died to make a way. And God wants to give us dreams to empower us to accomplish his task. And as he gives us those dreams, it's crucial that we hold on to these three things: to faith, to hope, and to love. Faith. We know according to Scripture that faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see, from Hebrews 11:1. Our dreams will require faith. Somebody say amen. Anybody ever given up on a dream because it was just too big? Anybody ever given up on a dream because it was just too big? Yeah, see, before, when you say you have a dream, everybody's like, I have a dream. And you ask, has anybody ever given up on a dream? And it's kind of like this. Maybe. Kind of. If our dreams are from God, they're going to require faith. There's going to require a measure of faith. We must believe that God can do anything. And see, the scripture says in Matthew 19:26, and this is Jesus saying that with man this is impossible, but with God. Say that with me, but with God. But with God. Look at your neighbor, say, but with God. But with God, all things are possible. Come on. With God, all things are possible. No dream is too big. No dream's too enormous. No dream's too outrageous. No dream's too unbelievable. Because with God, all things are possible. Don't let the devil tell you that your dream's not reachable. Because the reality is there's a lot of dream suckers in the world. There's a lot of things in this world that'll suck your dreams right out of your head. We can list some of them today. Everybody say people. But people can kill your dreams. You got to be careful who you share your dreams with. You know what I'm saying? We got to be careful who we share those dreams with. Sometimes people will wreck your dreams. Circumstances. It don't look like there's no way this is going to happen. But I got a dream right now that I'm sitting on, and I drive around every day in this city, and I keep listening to the enemy tell me, there ain't no way this is going to happen. I just keep reminding the enemy, well, you didn't give me this dream, so you ain't got no voice in it. It ain't your dream, it's God's dream. I drive around like, how in the world is this going to happen? Where? God, I want a church in this city. I want a building. I want you to do, God, you've given me a dream for this church. But faith is being certain of what we hope for, sure of the things that we can't see. And sometimes I can see it, but sometimes the enemy blinds me. And I have to keep reminding the enemy, Bupe, that it ain't your dream. You don't have control of it. You didn't give it to me. It don't belong to you. And we just keep dreaming. And we just keep allowing the Lord to breathe into that dream, to breathe into that dream. Caitlin, he's breathing into that dream, and he's going to make that dream come alive. But we just got to keep believing. We got to have faith. We got to have faith big enough for that dream. And then this morning, you got to have faith big enough for your dream, and that dream's going to stretch you, and you got to continue to have faith. But remember this, that God doesn't need us. God does not need us. But God needs us to trust him. God doesn't need us, but he needs us to trust him. Not to trust us, not to trust our resources, not to trust what we have, but to trust what he has. God doesn't need us, but he needs us to trust him. That's the faith that it takes to make our dreams become true. And as we continue to learn to trust him, our faith continues to grow and our dream continues to become a reality. Faith is like a muscle. And you continue to exercise it, it continues to grow. I believe God, Carol, for just a little bit. And then I'm going to believe him for just a little bit more. And I'm going to believe him for just a little bit more. And we're going to continue to work that faith out. And it's going to continue to grow. And all of a sudden, we're going to have the faith it takes to move mountains in Jesus' name. We're going to have a faith to accomplish whatever it is that God and the Holy Spirit has imparted inside of us. Why? Because God-given dreams come from God. And this whole faith thing has been a part of history. If you look in Hebrews chapter 11, so many times these two words are repeated over and over again. By faith. By faith. By faith. We know that by faith, Abel offered bigger sacrifice. By faith, Noah built an ark. By faith, Abraham obeyed and went. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau. By faith, Moses led Israel out of captivity. By faith, Rahab rescued the spies. By faith, by faith, by faith is how God's dreams come to reality. We must hold on to faith. We must exercise our faith. We must be willing to believe in the unseen. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Holy Spirit, help us dream today. Holy Spirit, breathe into the dreamers. By faith, dreams come true. Not only by faith, but in hope. Because you see, our hope feeds our dreams. Hope is simply our expectation and our desire. And the key to hope is being sure of who we hope for. The key to hope is being sure of who we hope for, not what we hope in. So many times we have dreams and we put our hope in other things or in circumstances or in other people, but the reality is the key to hope is where we place it. Our hope must be in him. Our hope must be in the Lord. Do not put your hope in money. Do not place your hope in money. Do not place your hope in your job. Do not place your hope in your surroundings, but place your hope in him. So many times we become discouraged because we hope in the wrong things. But we must put our hope in the one who gave us the dream to begin with. We must put our expectations in Him. We must put our desire in Him. The reality is that hope displaced, hope put in the wrong place, results in nothing but a crazy roller coaster ride of emotions. If we begin to put our hope in circumstances and those circumstances change, all of a sudden we lose hope. If we begin to put our hope in people and those people disappoint us, all of a sudden our hope begins to go down the drain. We put our hope in our job and our company goes under, we've lost all hope. We find ourselves on this crazy roller coaster ride of hope up, down, hope up, down, and all the time God's just saying, just hope in me. Put your hope in me. Put your hope in me. Our dreams are going to come true. We must put our hope in the Lord. Why? Because God is firm. God does not change. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is God. I love what Paul said in Romans 15, 13. He says, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him. Come on, Opie. You can say that amen louder. I see it. We talked this week about prison ministry. Come on. God will give us peace. God will give us hope as we place our trust in Him. He says that so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. By the power of the Holy Spirit, the one who gave us the dream, the one who imparted the dream, is the one who desires to empower us for the dream. Somebody say amen. Paul said, may the God of hope. Hello. If you lack hope this morning, turn to God. He's the God of hope. He's the God of hope. If you're feeling hopeless in your dream, turn to God this morning. He's the God of hope. There's faith, there's hope, and there's love. And why is love so important? Because of verse 21. So that all who call upon the name of the Lord must be saved. See, here's the reality is this, is if we're going to dream God's dreams, we got to be willing to love like God loves. If we're going to dream God's dreams, we have to be willing to love like God's love. Why? Because God's dreams are always tied to His purpose, and His purpose is to redeem the world. And if we're going to dream God's dreams, then we must love like God's love. Who and what we love affects how we dream. What do you love today? Are you rising above this morning, above and beyond? Set your hearts on things above. Set your minds on things above. What are you passionate about today? What do you love today? Who or what we love affects how we dream, and what we dream is tied to who or what we dream about. If we truly love God, He will truly give us dreams. If we truly love God, He will truly give us dreams. But we must be willing to ask ourselves this morning, can I be trusted with God's dream for me? We must be willing to lay ourselves on the altar of transparency and say, can I be trusted with God's dream for me? Lord, do I love the way you want me to love? Do I have faith enough to carry the dream that you're giving me? Is there hope enough inside of me? God, can I be trusted to dream the dream you have for me? We must be willing to ask ourselves that question this morning. God's dream for our lives are tied to what He loves. God loves people. God loves me. I know some of you are going, I don't know how. Trust me, there's days I look in the mirror and say, I don't know how. God loves me. God loves you. Come on. God loves you. God loves you, Chris J., more than you know. God loves you. God loves you. God loves you, Selvam. He's got a plan for your life, buddy. You know what God loves? Abby, God loves people. He doesn't care about things, but he loves people. Pastor Pam, God loves children. God loves families. I don't know where your family's at today, but I can tell you that God loves your family. Why? Because God instituted the family. That was his design. Not man's, it was God's. God loves you today. God loves the church. So God loves the church. God loves people. God's dreams will always be tied to what he loves. God loves people. God loves my neighbor. God loves my neighbor. God loves this city and God loves Tanzania. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son. God's dreams are tied to what God loves. God's dreams are tied to who God loves. God loves people. We must love people. Why don't you stand with me this morning? See, I believe this, that our God-given dreams are tied to our God-given destinies. And I believe for some of you this morning, God would look at you and say, I'm ready for you to dream again. It's been far too long. Why? Because if we stop dreaming, we start dying. Where there is no vision, people perish. Where there is no dream, things begin to fade away. But Effie, I got dreams, buddy. And the enemy may try to come, OG, and strip those dreams away from me. But the enemy didn't give them to me. He can't take them away, Carol. They're God-given dreams with God-given destinies. For me, for my family, for my marriage. Men, do you have a dream for your marriage? I hope so. You need to be dreaming for your marriage. All you husbands, you need to be dreaming for your marriage. All of you husband wannabes, you need to be dreaming for your marriage. Are you dreaming God's dream today? Because in the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit. And dreams and visions will follow. And because of that, all who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. God's dreams are always tied to God's destiny. Would you dream with me today? Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you for pouring out your spirit. Thank you for continuing to impart dreams. Thank you for continuing to trust us, God, with your dreams. Thank you for continuing to believe in us for your dreams. God, thank you for believing in us even when we don't believe in ourselves. God, I pray this morning that the power of your word and the power of your Holy Spirit would come and impart faith, hope, and love in those who maybe have given up on their dreams that you have given them, Lord. For those who've maybe backed away from the visions that you've imparted in their lives, Holy Spirit, would you breathe? Holy Spirit, would you breathe this morning? Would you breathe faith? Would you breathe hope? Would you breathe love? Would you breathe life into those dreams that are dead and bring them back to life? For you are the God of the resurrection. Would you resurrect those dreams that have died? Help us, Lord, to trust again. Help us, Lord, to have hope again. Help us, Lord, to have faith again. Help us, Lord, to believe again. And God, help us to love like you love. For if we will dream your dream, we must love as you love. God, help us to dream. Speak to us, Lord. Speak to your people. Speak to your church, even today, even today. If you're here this morning quickly and you'd say, Pastor Jimmy, I had a dream. God's given me a dream, but I've put it aside because it's too big or I haven't seen anything and nothing's pointing back to that dream and I've given up on it, but I don't want to give up on it. If that's you this morning, I want you to raise your hand. I want you to raise your hand because I want to pray for you this morning. I believe the Holy Spirit wants to breathe back into that dream this morning. I believe the Holy Spirit wants to breathe back into that dream this morning. Heavenly Father, you see these hands that are raised today. You know that the enemy has come and he's lied and he's cheated and he's stolen, God, what you've imparted. But we come back today and we claim it back in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, would you speak that dream again, even right now in the name of Jesus? Would you breathe that dream back into the dreamers? Oh, God, would you raise up the faith and the hope this morning that it requires to maintain those dreams? God, help them dream again. Help them to resurrect those dreams, Lord, and give them whatever they need to pursue them, Lord, to not lose heart and to not lose hope. But, God, let hope arise. Let hope arise. Let hope arise this morning, Lord. Let faith arise, Lord. God, would you breathe and would you stretch us and would you cause us to believe that, God, all things are possible with you. God, increase our faith this morning. God, re-breathe those dreams into each one of us today as we surrender ourselves, commit ourselves, God, to dreaming your dream and to loving the way you love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen.